So hello, hello everyone, Baysyde here, and welcome to another vlog episode. This time I can safely say I am up the creek without a paddle.
Without a paddle?
I dropped it in the water, and Mrs. B is holding it hostage. She won't give it back to me. That punk. So here I sit, floating, family vacation. We come out to this lake house, right around the same time every year, October, November. I don't often get stranded out here at the same time every year. So, I don't know if I'm ever going to do another episode, simply because I'm still stuck out here.
This is the end.
This is the last anyone has ever seen of me.
So, hi guys. Here we are inside this house. And of course, I hit record, Mrs. B makes noise. I am cursed to always have noise in the background. But as I said, here we are in the house. This is the living room. Has theater seats, all these recline out. And there's a bunch of movies and stuff. Moving around here to the front yard. There's Mrs. B dog. Mrs. B's dog. English, I know it, trust me. His name is Coco. Hi Coco. How you doing, Coco? Okay, you're gonna like kill me. Moving downstairs. Little bit of a wine cellar, bar, pool table, parlor area. Just outside the door here is the back deck patio. There's a hot tub I'll show you in a little bit. Moving into the garage that they furnished or refinished into a game room. You have the ping pong table. This I thought was kind of cool. I haven't seen one of these in forever. It's a Nintendo 64 and it actually works. And they have like a bunch of games, controllers, set up. It's great. Darts over there. I think all of these beds fold out into like for real beds. So you can have, in theory, six people sleeping in here. Moving back inside. Laundry, bathroom. This is the sister's bedroom. So again, in theory, two more people in here. I thought that was a bathroom. Okay. This is yet again another bedroom designed for four people. So apparently this is designed to be a kid's room. You have Peter Pan posters. I think there's a Cinderella poster over here. But so far we are up to, in theory, 10 people on just the basement level that can stay here. Obviously, we never bring 10 people, but... So heading back upstairs. He's a Coco boy. He's a Coco. He's a good boy. This was Mrs. B's and I room. Mrs. B and I... Forget it. English isn't my strong suit. So this is our view of our room. We spent most of our time on that water. That's actually where we filmed the kayaking scene. You can kind of see the kayaks down over there. Oh, we have a fly. We have a pet fly. I shall name you George. So heading down the hall, this was our bathroom, Mrs. B and I. This was the master bedroom where the parents stayed. Oh, so if you include our bedroom and this bedroom, I think we're up to 14 people that can stay in this house. But, yep, this is the master bathroom. They have a jacuzzi hot tub thing going on right there. Then they have their walk-in closet, their shower, these things. Okay, so down the hall here we have the dining room area. This table seats six, that table seats I think another six to eight people. So right there's 14 people, so I guess in theory, well here's two more, so there's 16 people. But most of the stuff here in the kitchen comes furnished, the toasters, the ovens, the blenders, stuff like that. We brought the bottle sterilizer for Baysyde. They gave us the high chair. That's not ours. Yes. So here's the view from the kitchen. Essentially the same thing from the bedroom. Up here you have the deck. If I remember how to open this door. Haha. I am not stupid. So here's the deck. Two gas grills. Gas comes furnished. You have gas heaters out here. Here's the view from the deck. So, you probably don't know this already, but I am already in my swim trunks. I'm gonna get my kayak on here in a moment once everyone comes back inside from the hot tub. And so I'm gonna wash the baby. So that's about all I have for the inside of the house. I'll show you the outside of the house. I hope the house wasn't too dark. I have no idea how bright the GoPro comes through, but I'm hoping it wasn't dark. All right, so here I am outside. This is the backyard. Well, we're gonna go down to the dock here soon. But here's the wonderfully somehow chemicalized green hot tub with the jets still on, which aren't supposed to be on.
Let me turn it off.
I got it. Nope. I guess that's how it's supposed to be. I'm leaving it. Here's the canoe that I kind of taught everyone how to use. The kayaks that you saw Mrs. B and I in that shed right there is a bunch of bicycles, outdoor stuff. I don't know if you can see that little flag thing over there. That's Frisbee Golf. There's basketball hoop out in front. And that's essentially the yard. So here I am for the last time on the water. For this year. Sorry, yes. For this year. I have my oar this time. Kind of sad to see this place go. But hey, what can you do? I spent the last 5 days here. And there goes Mrs. B. Bye, Mrs. B. I suppose I should come. I probably should go catch her. Well, I'm going to include some footage of a video game that I was playing on my cell phone. You can get it both on your cell phone, tablets, web browser. You can play it anywhere. But I'm going to include some footage of that. It helped me get through this trip and during the slow parts. So I hope you enjoy. But until next time, Baysyde out. So hey guys, here is the game I was mentioning earlier when I was on the water. This is called RPG.MO.EE. This game is available on just about every platform. It is a web browser-based game. They now have an app where I have been playing it on my cell phone. They have it on Steam. You can just essentially find this game anywhere on any platform now. And the best part is you sign in using the same account, so all your characters and everything are transferred to whatever platform you want. So right now I am playing on Steam, but the majority of the time I am playing in the web browser. If I'm out at doctor's office or something, I'm playing on my cell phone. And it's great how seamless and how everything just connects. It just works. That's the best part about this game. Now, here I am. You can see my character right here in the middle of the screen. I am decked out with mid-level gear. If I hover on myself, you can see up top that I am level 76 at the moment, which is semi-advanced considering there is a soft cap of 120 for character levels. The website address is rpg.mo.ee if you want to play online. If you want to just visit the website or download the PC version, download the app version, download any version you want, you can visit the website mo.ee. And that should take you right to this game. If you are looking for this game on Steam, it is just called RPG.MO or RPG space MO, I believe. Now, the real beauty of this game is how in-depth it is, how complete it is. Like, they really go into a lot of detail into everything. Like, for example, there are 5 combat skills and 10 professions that you can do. So, for example, here's fishing, woodcutting, and mining. Now, you also have farming, cooking, jewel crafting, carpentry, forging, alchemy, and breeding. Now, one really interesting thing about this game is that death is permanent. You can't go back and loot your body. Whatever was on you is lost, with some degree of exception there. But essentially, you lose the majority of your stuff. And a lot of these things can take a lot of time to obtain, a lot of money. So it's really, really painful in this game when you die. But I hope you guys enjoyed the game, and I hope to see you on there. So until next time, everybody, Baysyde out.